Please welcome from American Airlines, Vice President of Operations, Strategic Planning and Performance, Anne Moroni, and Director Operations, Schedule and Block Planning, Amit Shinde.
Good morning. So I hope your journey here was smooth, and I hope if you flew, that it was on American Airlines. So thank you for your business. My name is Anne Moroni. I'm the Vice President of Operations Planning and Performance at American, and I'm here with my colleague, Amit Shinde, who's our Director of Operations Strategic Planning. Our team's mission, to put it simply, is to build the best possible plan for the airline that will support our incredibly competitive network and deliver reliably, efficiently, and safely for you, our customers, every day. So with that, we're really excited to talk to you about our partnership with Palantir today and what we've been starting to do with Foundry and how we transform the way that we actually build our network. So nearly 100 years of innovation at American Airlines, and it's led us to be the largest airline in the world, carrying the most passengers and operating the most flight than any other airlines. 630,000 customers will fly on us today. To put it in perspective, that's 220 million passengers a year. 6,500 flights, that's about five times the size of the entire London Heathrow operation, will be operated today on American. And we do this with a phenomenal team, over 14,000 pilots, 24,000 flight attendants, 35,000 airport employees, and 6,000 mechanics who will work 24/7, 365 to run the operation safely. So our planning, bear with me for a minute. Imagine you're at a gate ready to board your flight. For that moment to happen, the planning has started long in the making to ensure that that aircraft is at that gate with the right crew, with fueling, catering, servicing on board, baggage and cargo loaded, the flight plan ready to go, security checks done, and the ground crew and ground equipment ready to push your aircraft. That planning starts months in advance and will go all the way to the day of operation, where an integrated operations center will actually dispatch your flight. It's an incredibly complex logistical problem. And unfortunately, as you can imagine, many of you in the room can relate, our current planning is incredibly manual, incredibly sequential, and unfortunately, as a result, quite siloed. So from outdated UIs, like you can see on the screen, Excel spreadsheets, attachments being sent via emails between teams, we spent an inordinate amount of time trying to actually build the best schedule we can. We rely on expert planners to weigh thousands of different variables and look at many different data points to find the balance between profitability and reliability. And as you can imagine, it doesn't leave a whole lot of room for optimization. Now, our schedule build starts at the core of it with demand, making sure that our network is the most competitive it can be to serve our customers' needs. But obviously, a lot of operational constraints need to factor in. Fleet is a big part of it, pilot hours, gate and infrastructure, airspace constraint, the time we need on the ground to maintain our aircraft and to turn our aircraft at the airport. All of that is built by our network planning team into a first version of a schedule that will then be sent over to all of our operational teams, who will then provide feedback, but also build their own plans. Workforce plan, workload plan, material plan, ground equipment plan, and you name it. Unfortunately, by the time a team finds an opportunity in the schedule, it is often too late to build in their original plan, or the solution they have in mind works great for them, but does not actually work for the enterprise. Fixing a crew issue could actually cause a maintenance issue if it's not thought through the right way. We have to solve earlier in the process as a network, and we have to solve on a continuous basis. Time is against us when we do this. Of course, the world changes. As we build those schedules, things change, and we need to be dynamic and competitive to respond to the market demands. So we set out to partner with Palantir to completely redesign this workflow and rethink the way that we do business. And it's been an incredible journey. In just about a year, we've already unlocked millions, tens of millions of dollars of value. The idea here is to actually collate all of this data and integrate the workflows between network planning and operations planning, and really unlock efficiencies that otherwise would not have even been visible to our people. The goal, again, here in what we've been building, is to do this continuously, dynamically, because the world keeps evolving. So with that, I'm going to pass it to Amit, who's going to take you a little deeper into what we've built.
Thank you, Anne. Good morning, everyone. So for the next 5 minutes, I want you to imagine that you're the world's best airline scheduler. Right? There's a very simple homework problem in front of us. We need to look at that incredibly complex chart that Anne showed, and we need to find all the inefficient patterns in it, and we need to provide solutions from those patterns that helps us operate a safe schedule, a reliable schedule for our customers, and most importantly, a profitable schedule as well. So what's an example of an inefficient pattern, right? So consider this example. I have a flight that is coming into San Francisco tonight, and there's a flight departing early morning from San Francisco. Those flight timings just are tight enough where the same crew doesn't have adequate amount of rest in between, and so the same crew cannot operate the flight that came in, and they cannot operate the flight that goes out. As a consequence, that crew has to sit in San Francisco, albeit a lovely city, for an extra day, and we have to ferry in another crew to operate the next day's flight. That's a highly inefficient pattern, right? And we have thousands and thousands of these embedded and hidden in the schedules that we need to go find. Over the last year or so, we've been on a journey with Palantir to try and reimagine our workflows on how do we effectively identify these issues, how do we localize where those issues are happening, and how do we actually fix them. So there's a lot going on the screen. This is a solution we call Vector. It's obviously built on Foundry, otherwise it wouldn't be here. But it shows us sort of the critical information, right? Like these are key performance indicators at the top. But there's something really interesting that is happening on the left-hand side of your screen, right? So if you look at the Crew Advisor module, you will realize that instead of us having to go hunt and peck where these inefficiencies are, those are actually being surfaced to me. Right? So these are recommendations that the models are scanning the entire network on, and they're saying there's something that I've found, you probably want to take a look at it. So let's go a little bit deeper into this. As I'm sort of going in a layer deeper, what I see is that it's recommending that my San Francisco flight needs to be retimed by 15 minutes, right? And you would think, like, okay, that's a really simple thing. Like, what's the big deal in that, right? You should be doing that in any case. The problem is this happens to be a notoriously difficult problem. That one flight retime is going to trigger a whole bunch of upstreams and downstream constraints that now come into conflict. And I need a mechanism where I'm starting to think through all of these different possibilities as I work through the schedule. To help us with this, there are models that are integrated in the background that provide live checks for me. Right? And these checks are looking at, am I creating a gating issue? Am I creating a turn issue? Am I violating any of my standards? Am I violating any of my site barriers? And those models are running continuously in the background. Right? The end result of this is, I'm going to come into this and you will realize that it's actually identified a conflict for me. So that 15-minute retime, even if I implement it, the models are now saying that, hey, you have a problem. You need to go resolve this through some of the mechanism. And in this case, instead of just dumping that problem in my lap, Vector is smart enough where it is actually going in and looking at what are the other possible ways through which you can solve out of this issue. And in this case, it's looking at some models, these are optimization models, that are saying if you just flow your lines a little bit differently, you have a really good solution, right? So that's what we are gonna do. We're not done yet though, right? So from a customer's experience, we need to make sure that any solutions, any augmentations of the schedule can operate not just on beautiful blue sky days that we see here in California most of the times, but also on gray sky days, right? When there are thunderstorms that are happening. So we have integrated network simulation models in the background that are constantly stressing our network, they're stressing our schedules, and they're trying to evaluate where are the choke points, where are the breakpoints in the network. So as you can see on the screen, it had identified a potential problem, And at the same time, if you follow the pattern here, it's also going to make recommendations on other edits that I need to do so that I can actually go ahead and fix out of it or solve out of it. This would be a terrible demo if that did not turn green. But this is an actual example. And as a consequence of this, right, so the initial proposition was you can save costs by retiming a particular flight. And you have to work through a whole bunch of layers on other constraints that you have to go solve for. And Foundry is sort of guiding our analysts, guiding our schedulers all the way through. At the end of it, I'm now confident that the solutions or the schedules that I'm putting out for you are safe, they're reliable, and they're profitable at the same time. With that, I'm going to hand it over to Anne.
So you saw the focus that we've had with Foundry has been on driving those efficiencies out of the network, and a great example that Amit walked through Crew. But the potential for this is a lot bigger, and we want to expand their use of Foundry into this integrated planning platform, the network planning all the way to all of our operational planning teams, and really collapse the workflows to find more areas for efficiencies like we have so far. We're incredibly excited. It's just been about a years-long journey. Like I mentioned, tens of millions of dollars already saved, and we can't wait for what's next. Thank you.